Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother, coming to you live from FEMA Region 4 here in the country, the land formerly known as the United States of America, the land formerly known as the home of the free, the land of the brave, and the home of the free. Brothers and sisters, I thank God. Listen to me, for all of you guys who are following this, things going on in the news. Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world. For if my kingdom was of this world, my followers would fight for me. But my kingdom is not of this world. Praise God. We're citizens of a land, as it says in Hebrews chapter 11. We're citizens of a land that those in the Old Testament only dreamed about. You know, people in the Old Testament had promises, but they never obtained that which was promised. I'm talking about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's talking there about in Hebrews chapter 11. They never obtained the promise, but that to their seed, that promise was given. Brothers and sisters, that natural land, as Hebrews tells us, Hebrews chapter 3 and chapter 4 also, there was another rest coming. There was another land. There's Beulah land. Now, when the Lord returns in the end, His will be done on earth as it is in heaven, brothers and sisters. Now follow me. Now, he who has an ear, let him hear. Let's go into the spirit realm. Let's stop with the baby milk now. Let's go on to the other side, to the deep side of the Word of God and the Spirit of God. You know, let's just peel back the curtains, the veil, and see what's on the other side. Follow me, brothers and sisters. It's so simple. Let that will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let that kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The Beulah land, the married land, the land of Israel, the natural land of Israel, the natural seed, the Israelites, the natural seed of Abraham, the natural land of Canaan, the promised land that God gave Abraham. Brothers and sisters, but there's a better covenant, the Bible tells us in Hebrews. A better land, a better promise, the Bible tells us. A better rest, Hebrews 3 and 4. A better land, a better rest, a better kingdom. A kingdom that's not of this world, brothers and sisters. Hidden in Christ right now, tonight, the kingdom of heaven. Those of us who are born again, we're hidden in Christ. We're behind the veil in the Spirit, in the church invisible, the church universal. In that spirit realm, brothers and sisters. And when we, the bride, the church, are raptured and caught up, we will take off this corruptible body, this lead body, and we will put on that gold body. Those things that the devil's people have been seeking after with alchemy and all of this magic and all that stuff to obtain incorruptible flesh, to obtain eternal life through the tree of knowledge and good of and evil. We, brothers and sisters, have obtained eternal life through the tree of life, even Yeshua HaMashiach, who hung on the tree, became sin for us, who took the curse of the law of sin and death upon himself, the Bible tells us, that we might be partakers in the promises of Abraham, brothers and sisters. All that I'm telling you right now, it's totally from the Spirit of God. I had no idea what I was going to say when I started making this video. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Hear what I'm telling you. Here is wisdom. Not that you love God, but that God loved you and gave himself for you. That he first loved us, Paul says. Hallelujah. As Jesus told his disciples, you didn't choose me, I chose you. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. You know, that the Lord chose us to be his children, to be his servants. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. All day long that Israel rejected the Messiah. Praise God that we might be saved. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God for the church age. Praise God that he has given us Gentiles, the kingdom. He has given us such a time as this that we may be alive and remain to be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. Praise God. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. Through whom all blessings flow. Listen to me, brothers and sisters. Those devil's people. See, they think that they can go to the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, as even Eve heard from the serpent. Oh, God doesn't want you to eat the fruit from that tree, because when you do, you will become like God. Since that time, after they were put out of the Garden of Eden, the children of the of wickedness, you know, we're all born in sin. People have sought that gnosis, that knowledge, that wisdom, that they might find a back doorway back into the Garden of Eden, back into heaven, their own way. Listen to me, brothers and sisters. All religions, when I say religions, I don't mean a personal relationship with Jesus Christ and a follower of Jesus Christ. It's not a religion. All other ways outside Jesus, all roads lead to Rome, as the old saying goes. And Rome represents the world, Babylon, destruction. All roads really lead, another way of saying it at another level, all roads lead to the foot of Mount Hermon, where the fallen angels came down, making themselves as gods to the people and leading silly women astray that they might produce that offspring, as we see in Genesis chapter 6, the Nephilim. The sons of God married the daughters of men, and it gave us the Nephilim. As the days of Noah were, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be, the Lord Jesus told us. Follow me, brothers and sisters. All the roads of religion lead back to Mount Hermon. They all lead following trails of the tree of knowledge, of gnosis, of Gnosticism. All of these ancient wisdoms lead to one place, to death, hell, and the grave, to destruction. The same thing that befell the Nephilim, destruction. Sudden destruction came upon them, and they could not escape. The Nephilim, those sons of the fallen angels, destroyed. Brothers and sisters, that same thing is about to happen, as we know. We call it the tribulation period, that 7-year period, when things will be as it was those in those days, brothers and sisters. And listen to me, you need to tell all people, anyone watching this video, if you don't know, Jesus declared, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. Jesus Christ said, that is the only way to the tree of life, is through our Christ who hung on the tree. Hallelujah. Praise God. He hung on the tree, became sin for us, took the curse of sin and death from us, and imparted to us his righteousness, a righteousness that is by faith, the Bible says. By grace are ye saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God. Not by the works that you can do, so that no person can boast. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, that Jesus Christ is the only way. And he took upon himself our sicknesses and our diseases, the Bible said. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. All of our sin was laid on the Messiah, Yeshua, when he was on that tree. Hallelujah. Can you imagine God took the tree of life and used it for death of the Messiah, that it would be life eternal for us, brothers and sisters? Praise God. Praise God. We are spiritual Israel. We partake of the root and the promises of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Romans 9:10-11. We receive those blessings by faith, by grace through faith. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, that we would find the tree of life. So anyone who's watching this video, there is only one way to walk with God in the cool of the day. One way to walk with God in the cool of the day. And that is by grace through faith in the finished work of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. Only one way is through Jesus. Put all your faith, your hope, your trust in Jesus. I ask you to pray with me right now. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, Father, I believe. I believe your word, Lord. I believe the good news that Jesus died for me, Lord. You don't have to say the exact words. Just call upon the name of the Lord. Lord Jesus, save me. Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I know I'm lost. I know that without you, I'm not going to heaven. I need you, Jesus, to save me. I need you, Lord Jesus, to forgive me of my sins. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Lord Jesus, rule and reign in my life. Lord, I give my life into your hands, Lord. You are the potter and I am the clay. As that song says, I give my life into the potter's hands. Hallelujah. Lord, conform me to the image of Christ. Lord, set my feet upon a rock. Lord, lift me up out of the miry clay, the miry pit I've been wallowing in, Lord, with uncleanness, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, with thy spirit and thy word and in the blood, hallelujah, that cleanses me of all unrighteousness. Father, I receive redemption by your blood. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for setting me free. For your word says, Lord, you, Jesus, said, those whom the Son has set free are free indeed. Hallelujah. Free in Christ today. Free from the laws of sin and death, hell and the grave. Free from the power of Satan, of darkness, of deception, of destruction, of addictions. Free, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, free at last. That's true freedom. Not of the world, but freedom in Christ, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Set your affections on things above. Hallelujah, brothers. Not to the second heaven, where the Gnostics look and all these religions look. To the as above, so below of the second heaven, reflect on earth. But look to the third heaven. Where is the Christ? Look to heaven where God is. And let that reflect in you. Just as God told Moses on the mountain, build the tabernacle and the ark and all those things after the pattern that I showed you on the mountain of what's in heaven. Brothers and sisters, there's a pattern in heaven that God has given us through his word. A pattern for us to be conformed to the image of Christ. A pattern of repentance. A pattern of taking up your cross daily and following Jesus, as he said. A pattern of walking in holiness. A pattern of walking in righteousness. A pattern of deliverance. A pattern of boldness. A pattern of the Spirit. A pattern of the gifts of the Spirit. A pattern of healing. A pattern of deliverance. A pattern of rapture. A pattern of discipleship. A pattern of evangelism. Hallelujah. God has given us all things, hallelujah, in Christ Jesus. What's your excuse now? What's your excuse now when God has moved heaven and earth to set you free and deliver you? What is your excuse now? I asked you, oh church, what is your excuse when the Master has given you all things? The money, the dreams, the visions, the Spirit. All things have been given through Christ. So what is your excuse, church? Rise up and condemn wickedness in high places. Rise up and bring conviction on the lost with my word, says the Lord. Hallelujah. For I am holy and meek. Hallelujah. And lowly and humble in spirit, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For my burden is easy and my yoke is light. Oh church, walk in your destiny. Walk in my will. Walk in the pattern that I showed you when you came up on the mountain, says the Lord. I've shown many of you the pattern on the mountain, but yet you didn't build what I commanded you to build. Build my kingdom. Build my kingdom, says the Lord God, Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah, for I put my spirit in you and on you and to you and through you. Hallelujah, to inhabit you, that you might inhabit my kingdom. Hallelujah, in the dwelling places I have made for you, in my Father's house, says the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For the end is near, says the Lord. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Don't be slow of speech. Do not be slow of speech, but be quick. Be quick, says the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For I know how to deliver my people out of the snare of the enemy. Hallelujah. I know how to deliver my people from the clutches of death, hell, and the grave. I gave this same word, the same exact words the Lord gave me a few weeks ago when I made a video. It's the second time the Lord has said that. He knows how to deliver us out of the snare of the fowler, to snatch us. The word snatch is the harpozo word, meaning snatched, to be snatched up, to be caught up, forcibly taken. God bless you guys. You can count that one. That is of the Spirit, of spoken by the Spirit of the Lord. God bless you guys. I love you all. Praise the living God. I'm going to post these videos. This is late Thursday night after midnight. I get these posted Saturday. We've got lots of people coming for the baptism. Praise God. I don't know how many. At least 10 plus. I don't know the count. I haven't counted it. But praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. For those people who will be baptized to be obedient to the Lord. As an act of obedience, as a new Christian, to be baptized. Praise God. Any more people anywhere near Charlotte within a drive, come on down. Be baptizing. If you need to be water baptized and you're anywhere near where I'm at in North Carolina, please get with me. Chicago, Minneapolis, end of July, the last week of July, I'll be there. Minneapolis and Chicago. And all points in between, I'll be driving up there. So, time to get right. Time to make peace with God. Time short. Blah, 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 you know. Let's, you know, short version. Time's up. Let's get it done. Get her done. Let's make it happen. I just realized, too, old Larry the Cable Guy is from Minnesota. And he says, get her done. There you go. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. You know, praise God. You know, I always try to, I guess the Lord always leads me that I always try to say something that's human. Because lots of times people get this perception that, either A, they think preachers are supposed to be perfect, or B, they get the impression that, he's so righteous, then I'm ashamed to talk to him and things like that. Brothers and sisters, everybody's human. The only time I'm like, that the righteousness, the manifested righteousness when the Spirit comes on me, when I'm ministering to people, doing the ministry. You know, when I'm not praying or serving the Lord and all that, I mean, I'm just a normal person just like everybody else. It's when the Spirit of the Lord would come on me to use me, that I'm the way that I am, by the Spirit. It's not the same as when I'm just walking down the street. You know, unless the Spirit is moving, that's what empowers me and you, when God is using us as an instrument in His hand. It's all Him, brothers and sisters. Apart from Him, I can do nothing, the Bible says. But with Christ, all things are possible, Jesus said. And then Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. Christ is the hope of glory. He's the hope of glory. What's the glory? We're talking about the rapture. Glorified body. Christ is the hope of glory. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you guys.